flies in the back of my head. I got eyes.
Wow, wow, wee!
In the back of my head, got eyes.
I believe you.
Eyes in the back of my head. I got eyes. There'll be no hesitating.
I just can't feel us waiting. My heart's not palpitating.
You can't get through.
My skin's got love's button.
That ain't too much of nothing. Do it, do it, do it in my shoes. Hey,
hey,
hey, hey, hey. I got eyes.
You got what?
Eyes in the back of my head. I got eyes.
Wow, wow, wee.
In the back of my head. Got eyes.
I believe you.
Eyes in the back of my head. I got eyes. There'll be no hesitating.
I just can't feel us waiting. My heart's not palpitating.
You can't.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, my very special friend, Melissa Manchester.
A bunch of weary voices I mistook for angels. Telling me what to do with my life, leaving me no choices and putting me through changes and telling me what to do with my life. Oh, I'm sure I won't be back for more. My caravan, oh, I'm sure I'll
you.
Melissa, who do you listen to? What singers do you like?
I listen to, the first person, when my parents first bought a hi-fi player, I think I was about 7 years old, and the first LP record that they brought home was Ella Fitzgerald sings Gershwin. And then, I lived on that. And then I listened to Judy Garland and Tony Bennett and Frank Sinatra, all the crooners, you know. Yes. And then I listened to the Beatles. And I don't know, I just started to get involved in songwriting with some friends of mine. I found that writing songs, I think the reason I started writing songs was because I couldn't remember anybody else's lyrics. And so, it's true. So, because I would make up my own lyrics to familiar tunes.
Really?
Yeah.
It happens to me the other way around.
You can't remember your
own
lyrics.
Is it true? I can't remember my own lyrics.
I know. But I don't know. I've just always been, I've found a great deal of peace in listening to music. And music has always made a lot more sense to me than the world at large. And I don't know about how you feel about
that. It's true.
It's
it's like a higher state.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody loves music.
Emotions become clearer sometimes, you know. But I was always surrounded by music. Well, you were always surrounded by music.
Yeah,
and your
my
family.
Parents were singers.
Yeah.
So I was born almost in a trunk on the road.
Did you listen? You're born in a trunk. Yeah. Did you listen to classical music a lot?
Oh, yes. Yeah. Not so much. I liked Barbara Streisand.
Yeah.
And the Beatles. I was a Beatles fan.
Right.
Very much.
Oh, right.
And I always was surrounded by South American folkloric music. It's very strange, you know?
The rhythms.
But that's what my parents used to sing.
Yeah, it's true. South America is to you like Brooklyn is to me.
That's
it's
right.
Just another borough of the world.
That's right. That's and I loved Brazilian music.
Best. The best.
Wonderful.
Yeah, the rhythms are incredible.
They're so ahead in music, you know? It's
yeah.
Not commercial. It's not
I know.
Commercial music.
You think? Do they think that they're ahead, or do they not know?
No, they. That's the way they are. That's their music.
Oh,
but I think
incredible.
They're ahead.
Oh yeah. Oh, the rhythms are just beautiful.
It's beautiful.
Yeah.
You have a big hit now. A wonderful song. It was written by Peter Allen and Carol Bayer-Sager.
Right. Don't
it's a
cry
beautiful
out loud.
Song.
Yeah. Thank you. It was very strange when I started to sing it. We were talking about lyrics before. When I first started singing it. It was the strangest thing because usually when I write songs, I try to write about feeling your feelings and letting go of your feelings and crying out loud and laughing, ha ha ha. And all of a sudden, this song is saying, don't show it. You know,
yes.
Don't show it. And as I was singing it, I was getting so frustrated, you know, because. And then finally, I broke through and I went, don't cry out loud. And it worked, you know. Whatever
yes, that's
works.
That's true.
Yeah?
I thought of it when I heard the song.
Yeah. But they're wonderful writers, and it's nice having. It's like an old school where all of your friends are also writers. So if you call them up and say, do you have an extra song or whatever? I actually heard Peter sing it first on his live album. And it was interesting because he was singing the song to another person. And I find that, I didn't realize when I started singing, but I think one sings a song to oneself sometimes. Sometimes, you know, you find that you can sing a song to another person and end up really singing it to yourself.
Yes.
That's really nice. It opens up
Who
the
did
doors.
You sing it to?
I think I sang it to myself and I started crying like that.
Yeah, like sometimes you get mad because you want to hide your feelings and you can't.
Oh,
so
sure.
You can look at it that way too.
Sure. But it was nice. It's nice to sing songs like that.
Do you write songs mostly on the road or when you're relaxed at home?
I find that I write a lot when I'm in motion, when I'm on the road.
Yes.
Whether it turns it into a song or not, I don't know. But I think that the motion intensifies what the whole experience of writing is about, which is very solitude. Oriented, and it's like the eye of the storm. It's the quietest place in the midst of all of the motion, you know. And I find a lot of peace from writing. Do you?
Oh, very much.
Mm-hmm.
And I write mostly when I'm on the road. I feel like, you know, I have a companion, my guitar.
Yeah.
I write with the guitar.
Yeah,
you know, that's how.
Exactly.
And Melissa, good luck to you. And thank you for being here. And I really want to hear another song.
All right. baby cried the day the circus came to town. 'Cause she didn't want parades just passing by her. So she painted on a smile and took up with some clown. While she danced without a net up on the wire. I know a lot about her, 'cause you see, baby is an awful lot like me. Just keep it inside and learn how to hide your feelings. Fly high and proud, and if you should fall, remember you almost had it all. Oh, you saw that when they pulled that big top down, behind her dreams among the litter, and that different kind of love she thought she found. There was nothing left but sawdust and some glitter. But baby can't be broken, 'cause you see, she had the finest teacher, that was me. Told her, don't cry out loud, just keep it inside, learn how to hide your feelings, fly high and proud, and if you should fall, remember you almost had it
with a day that's gray and lonely. I just pick up my chin and grin and say, with a day that's gray and lonely, I just pick up my chin and grin and say,
tomorrow, I love you, tomorrow, you're only a day away.
great evening, and I want to thank my very special friends, wonderful, the Chromatics, Night Flight, Liz Torres, and of course, Melissa Manchester, and you, for being with us. To my friends, a thank you song for being
and production members of Lucette and some very special friends stayed at Miami's beautiful Omni International Hotel in downtown Miami.